Oh, the other graph.
Uh-huh.
Cool.
Let's get back.
Why were salt 1 and salt 2 so ineffective? They actually increased the number of weapons.
Well, because what they were primarily designed for was to supposedly reduce the probability of first strike and allow for the ability to strike second. That's what they were supposed to do. But initially, they didn't even do that, according to the critics. And it was, well, we got to get into the practice of agreeing so that we can get to that goal. And the critics, which actually helped produce Ronald Reagan's victory, the Committee on the Present Danger, you can look that up, and it helped create the National Defense Security Memorandum that pretty much outlined the general idea of competing to put pressure on the Soviet Union to stop doing things we don't like them to do, which was a little bit, it had to be said because we kind of lost our way on that point. Those agreements, SALT I and SALT II, allowed for limits on the delivery systems, but not on the warheads. And what happened is there was a guy named Al Ladder, and he was at RAND. He ran, I think, the physics department, and he wanted to make money, so what do? You leave, and you create your own think tank. And he noticed that there was something called a satellite dispenser that had been perfected, and you could put 5 or 6 satellites, shoot the whole bus up, and it would release satellites precisely into orbit. He said, well, why don't we put warheads on that? And that's what we did. And that's what they did. And so the warheads went up, even as the delivery systems were controlled. Does that? Okay. You see, you ask. Sometimes you get an